Ben Goldberger joins us now. He's executive editor at Time Magazine. Ben, good morning.
Good morning.
Let's start with Joe Biden. Is he in, do you think? Is there any hesitation with these new accusations?
I think there's always been hesitation with Biden. He wanted to run 4 years ago and ultimately decided not to. Yeah. It's certainly possible that he doesn't, but all signs point to yes. He's effectively built a shadow campaign. Many of his former colleagues in the Senate that he's spoken to believe he's going to run. And he's, most importantly, tapped a lot of potential big-ticket fundraisers so that they're at the ready the moment he announces.
Is he the centrist that Democrats are looking for?
Well, so that's the fundamental question. This Democratic primary field is historically broad and diverse. And Joe Biden has much to recommend him. Decades of legislative experience and accomplishment. He was the vice president for a president who remains enormously popular within the party. Huge name recognition that vaults into the current top of the polls, above that of even President Trump. But what the party winds up choosing will determine not just the fate of the Democrats, but potentially the country, and reshape it much as the nomination of Donald Trump did 4 years ago.
He'd be the oldest U.S. president in history. If
Indeed.
The party's trying to shape a sort of an image, a new image for the future, is that what you want?
Well, and that's the argument that many of even Biden's own supporters are making right now, that he may well be potentially qualified, and were this another election cycle, he should have been the person. In fact, Jennifer Palmieri wrote a piece in the new issue of Time that I thought made a very smart point about exactly this, that the longing for Biden may well represent a certain form of kind of nostalgia that is part of Democrats' 2016 healing process more than it is a expectation of where they believe they should be going.
Let's move on to immigration. The president threatened to shut down the border last week. This week he says we can't take any more people here. I mean, how does this jive with the notion of give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses? I mean, will this be a potential landmine for Republicans?
Certainly, and it has been. I mean, the president beat the drum for the wall throughout, not just his own campaign, but the 2018 midterms, and it certainly helped cost his party the majority in the House of Representatives. Right now, he's conflating two fundamentally different issues. We do have a very serious problem with the asylum system in this country, but the notion that the United States is somehow full is absolutely false. We remain one of the least densely populated major nations in the world, and we also have what demographers call a real replacement problem, which means that we are not having enough people born as we have people growing old.
The House Democrats filed a federal lawsuit to block the president from spending more money on his border wall on Friday. Is this a lawsuit that's likely to get bipartisan support?
A few things get bipartisan support right now. I mean, you know, that's the fundamental answer, which doesn't mean that it won't gain traction.
Yeah.
I mean, what these attorney generals are doing is taking a page out of the playbook of their predecessors under Obama, where many Republican attorneys general filed similar suits on the grounds of federal overreach.
I have to talk about the president and taxes because the Democrats are making a move calling on the IRS to release them. How far will they get with this?
Potentially very far, which doesn't mean that it won't be litigated to the hilt and that the president will not continue his campaign of discrediting it from the jump. We've already seen that the response from his personal lawyer is very similar to the response from his personal lawyer once the Mueller investigation began, which is to discredit the very premise, consider it a witch hunt, and attempt to sway public opinion.
All right, Ben Goldberger, thanks so much for being with us this morning.